Hi friends, welcome back. So in this video we are going to explore the two another concept in a Python. One is a dictionary kind of data set and another is a set data structure. In a last video we have seen a two different data structure. One is a list data structure and another one is a tuple data structure. In a list and a tuple, in a both place we have found that the indexing is starting from 0, 1, 2. So all are the integer based indexing and all those indexings are starting from 0 onwards. But let's say we want to make some indexing like some alphanumeric value. Let's say we want to make something like a key 1 associated with the value 1. It's kind of dictionary way of storing that something is associated with something else. Some other thing is associated with some other thing. So let's create a very simple this dictionary in a key value pair kind of data set. So let's define a variable dict. Now to create the dictionary, we need to use this curly braces and all those elements will be separated by the comma. So before comma, we will create one element and after comma, we will create another element. So let's create a first element which is associated key 1 with a value 1 and key 2 associated with the value 2. So every single element in a dictionary data structure we can access through this key 1 as a indexing and key 2 as a index rather than supplying a very hard coded index like a 0, 1, 2, 3 as we have seen in a last video in case of list data structure. So let's associate this key 1 to the value 1 and key 2 to the value 1 and create the dict variable. So first let's just write the key 1. After that colon and then associated value. So it's a val1. And another element, same way we will write like a key 2 val2. We have created the dict object. Now let's see the type of this dict. So you can say that this is the dict kind of objects. And I have created this variable name also dict. So let's not get confused. This is the variable name and this is the type of object. Now let's say we want to grab some particular value associated with some keyword or some key. So we can just use like a dictionary and in a square brackets we can supply like a key one. So rather than supplying this integer based indexing in case of list, here we can use this alphanumeric based key indexing. So key one is associated with val one, key two is associated with val two. Now you can see that in this case, in both the key has been associated with some string. So val1 and val2 is string. But instead of this val1 and val2, you can even keep even more complex object also. So any kind of custom object you can use instead of this simple string val1 and val2. So that is all about the dictionary. So dictionary in a one liner, you can say like a key value pair kind of database. So if you want to store something like a phone number is associated with some contact name. So every contact name is associated with some phone number. In that kind of storing purpose, you should use the dictionary database. Now let's see about the set. So set is nothing but a unique set of element. So to create the set, let's just create a very simple set of element. Let's say 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. So it has written 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now there is no single element is repeating. So whatever the input data set we have supplied in a curly braces, which is all separated by the comma, and it has returned a set, which is also having a 5 element. Now let's just append one more, something like a 5. So you can see even if I appended the 5, the output has not given a 2 5, but it has given just 1 5. So whenever you append the new content or new element in a set data structure, it will keep finding that whether that particular element already exists or not. Basic property of this set is nothing but there is no repeating element. There is a unique set of element contained in a list. Now let's just assign it to the st. Let's just print this st. Now all those methods which we have used in case of this list data structure, we can apply it here also. So let's just append. Okay, instead of append we have a method like a add. So let's just add 10 and let's just print this st. So you can see that now 10 has been included because 10 was not exist earlier. 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, there is no 10 exist. But now again, let's see, we want to add like 3, and let's just print st again. So you can see that there is no 3 admin has been added again, because the basic property of this set is nothing but the unique set of element you want to retain in your list. That is what the set data structure is. So in this video, we have seen about the two important data structure available in a Python. One is a dictionary data structure and another one is a set data structure. So I hope you enjoy listening this video, and see you into next video.